Hey guys, today I'm going to do a review for you on the Audioengine D1 headphone amplifier and DAC digital audio converter. So I've had this guy for a while now. I got it on when it launched, and I've been pretty happy with it. It retails for $169 on the internet, and I think that for the size that it is and the performance, it's really a winner. I'm going to show you what it's got, and then tell you about the sound quality and what you can do with it. So you have your volume control. There is no on-off switch on the volume itself, so it's just a knob. Now the on-off switch is right here, where it says power, so you turn that on and off. And then you have your mini jack for your headphones, and then on back you have a pair of RCA outputs for your amplifier, and then a digital input, and then a USB B input. So it came with a nice carrying pouch. Now I wish that the carrying pouch was larger, because it was kind of hard to fit it into the bag. You see that? Barely fits into the pouch. I wish that it was a hard carrying case and slightly larger, where that way I can fit the DAC and the USB cable that it comes with. It's a decent quality USB cable. I don't know who makes it, but it's decent quality. I mean, it's about 3 feet or so. So now, from my experience on this guy, that the sound quality, it's very good. It's slightly forward in terms of sound, but it's not at all in a bad way. I kind of like it. I think it pairs really well with Sony headphones. The one that comes to mind would be the MDR-V600. It pairs very well with that. The Audio-Technica M50, it's also a winner with that. And the AKG, the entire AKG line, pairs really well with it. So I'm very happy with this guy. So it's quite versatile, and sounds really good. So when you hook this guy up, before I go forward, now you don't get a power adapter with this. So to use the digital input here, you need to power it up. So they sell, Audioengine sells a power adapter for $18. It's a USB A to USB B power adapter. This end goes to the power adapter, and this end goes to the DAC right here, like this. So for me, I found that to save myself $18, this little guy right here that came with my Apple thing, I think it came with the iPad, but you know, I've got a drawer full of these things, worked well with it. So you plug it in like so, and then you plug it into the wall, which now will allow you to use the optical digital input right here. We'll just uncap it. Oops. And then there's your optical input. So what that allows you to do is bring new life into your old CD player, if you have one of those sitting around still. And I think that for the performance of this guy, if you have a 10-year-old CD player and you want to add a more modern sound to it, this is a good product to do that. And then all you have to do is hook this guy up to an amplifier, and then there's your preamp right here with the volume control. So it's a great product, very versatile. But mainly, I suggest you guys to use it with is a laptop and a headphone. So as you can see, I have my MacBook Air in front of me. This is a 11-inch MacBook Air. You plug it into the USB jack, For me, the 11-inch MacBook Air, this USB right here is a higher grade USB output. It's not shared with any other USB device inside the laptop. The one on this side is shared with the keyboard, the screen, and all that stuff. So you don't want to use that. You want a good clean source from the USB to your D1. So from my experience, when you plug it in, you want to go to Audio MIDI, which is right here. I'm not sure you can see that. We'll bring that forward. So Audio MIDI controls the audio source for the computer. Hope you can see that better. Now, as you can see, once I plugged it in, the Audioengine D1 is automatically selected. So it defaults to that immediately. Now you have a 24 or 16-bit option. This is a 24-bit DAC, so you want to select the 24-bit. For me, most of my files are 44.1 sample rate, which is CD quality. And now I noticed that if you set it to 44.1, it sounds good. But if you set it to 88.2, it sounds even better. A little bit more air, a little bit cleaner sound. It's very small difference. You'll need some very revealing headphones or a pair of speakers to really hear the difference, but the difference is there. So if you can choose 88.2 for your CD quality sample rate, and then once you select that, and that's it, you just turn close Audio MIDI and fire up iTunes. Now the USB input on the Audioengine is not asynchronous. It's an adaptive USB mode, which for me it doesn't really matter. It sounds fantastic. A lot of people say that asynchronous is best because it eliminates jitter. But you know, for me, for $169, this is really a great DAC and a headphone amplifier. And yeah, I think that for portable use, because of the size, and you pair this up with your MacBook Air, you really have a fantastic listening music server station for mobile use. Now, like I said, pair it up with a good pair of headphones. I like the V600. It's a Sony MDR V600 a lot because it folds up nicely and it comes with a pouch. The Audio-Technica ATH-M50 also is really nice. It also folds up and comes with a pouch. So, you know, you add those three items up, the headphones, the Audioengine D1, and then your laptop. You got a pretty serious audio listening station, music listening station for the road. You know, I mean, plug it in and you're off. It's a fantastic DAC for $169. I think you should go out and listen to it. Now, Audioengine sells the D1 directly through their website, and they offer a 30 days money back guarantee. So if you don't like it, send it back and no hard feelings. So it's a fantastic deal. I think you should check it out. I certainly love mine. I enjoy it a lot. And I think you should go out and give it a try. So this is my short review of the Audioengine D1, the headphone amplifier and DAC. I think it's a great unit. And if you'd like to see more unboxings and reviews, please subscribe. I like to bring you guys more hi-fi gear, and I'm trying to reach out to manufacturers to support my channel. So the more subscribers I have, the better, and the better chance I'll get anything. So if you like my channel, please subscribe and like it on Facebook and Twitter and whatever you use for social networking. I am on Twitter. You can reach me on Twitter relatively quickly. YouTube, the way their comments and the way you reply on comments is just funky on the iPhone. A lot of times I just don't get to reply to your comments quickly because I'm on the iPhone a lot, and it doesn't allow direct replies, or at least it doesn't work on the iPhone. So follow me on Twitter, HiFiGuy528, and please subscribe. Thanks for watching. See you next time.